Hello everyone, this video will be about the laboratory exam. I have written a template in order to explain certain aspects of the exam and to be hopefully helpful to you. Now, basically the laboratory exams will be consisting of MATLAB functions or MATLAB code that you should write basically, and that will focus on your MATLAB knowledge and or some theoretical aspects. Well, here we have an example that I've prepared here. We are asked to write a MATLAB function that has a name polyroots, which obviously takes a polynomial and calculates the roots. Now, there will be much more explanation and test cases in the PDF that you will face, but here, since this is an example, I've kept it simple. Now, the question asks here us to have certain limitations on inputs or outputs, and some requirements. Now, the limitation here is to have the polynomial to be a symbolic expression of S. Now, therefore, we should be careful with that. The arguments should be symbolic expressions of S. And then the return should be a double vector. So, and since there is a template here, it's easy to copy and then prepare a function. So let's paste it in. Let's first copy and paste. So poll and then poll roots. So it is important to name the function exactly as it is given in the PDF here. So we have this poll, and basically it is told to us that it should look like, for example, this. So this will be the polynomial. Therefore, I need a symbolic S here. And the input should look like this. Now, the task is pretty easy here in this case. We can use, for example, coefs in order to get the coefficients of the provided polynomial. And let's store it in coef. And then we can use directly the roots function here because it is possible in this case. I didn't prepare a very sophisticated example. It's just a trivial one. Therefore, we have already a code that can deal with the task that is given here. This is pretty much the question for this template. And we will save it. Let's get rid of this line. So you should prepare basically the function here. Now we can test this out. We have a symbolic S, and then we can just use polyroots and then provide some polynomial. 2 times S plus 1, for example, and I can see that it certainly works. So -1 and -1 are the roots of this. I did stick to the fact that the input argument should be symbolic, therefore I've provided a symbolic. There will be some test cases probably, but here I kept it simple. So, now once you're done, once you've coded your MATLAB function, then there's the submission part that is important. Due to some previous experiences, I have included some notes for you here. And the reason for that is the following. Now, the function should be named as polyroots because that's given here. Don't use any other name, and it could be also a good practice to use poll and poll roots here, but they don't really matter. The function name is crucial though. So once you're done during the submission, you have to use your student ID, for example something like this here, .m. Now of course now you can not use this MATLAB function, but during the submission you will submit something like this, student ID .m. Now this will be submitted to Ninova and Ninova only, and your submission should be a valid MATLAB file. Now if the submission is not a valid MATLAB file, it will not be graded or taken into consideration. If it's not a working function, then again, it will not be regarded. So you shouldn't basically prepare this code, copy it to, for example, a word processor like Office Word, or in a PDF, and then change the .pdf or .doc into M, it should be a valid MATLAB file. So let me summarize it to you. You will be asked to design a MATLAB function. It should be a working M file, it should be a function, the function name should be the same, the arguments should be appropriate, they should align with the requirements and limitations in the PDF provided. In this example, we did see that the pol should be a symbolic expression of variable s, then it should work for these type of inputs. And the output should be a vector of doubles, then it should be again a output of doubles. Now, what else do we have? Now, if your code is not working, if it's not saved as studentid.m, or if it's not a function, if it's not a valid MATLAB function, etc., etc., be careful of these cases. Of course, cheating is prohibited, so don't cheat. I can, for example, write this function a bit different. I can directly use the polynomial here. I can use sol equals solve, and then I could provide it polynomial equals zero, and I can use this solution and convert it into double sol, and this should also work. So basically, there are different versions here that are possible to use. Of course, I did change the name, so therefore it's not working. Let me change it back. So there we go. So it works. So there are different ways of accomplishing the same task. Therefore, please try to solve it on your own. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Submit it to Ninova. You will have a certain time interval, so there will be a time limitation here, but you should be okay. If you're familiar with the laboratory sessions, if you're familiar with MATLAB and some theoretical aspects, you should be able to do the job in this case. So that's pretty much it. Good luck in your laboratory exam.